595 from Sierra Oscar receiving.
Right.
Do you need assistance
in catching the suspect? Over.
I suppose you think that's funny, George.
He's disappeared again. Tony.
I'm gonna kill him.
Well, now's your chance. Come on.
What's going on?
Kingsley O'Lear is causing trouble on the Netherlands, Sarge.
Yeah, I might have guessed.
Where is the scotch?
I don't know what you're talking
about. Don't mess
about.
Me about, Kingsley. We saw it. It was in your hands.
Well, where is it?
We'll soon find out.
He can't deny it, you know. It was a full litre of scotch. And there were witnesses as well.
Look, it's probably best if you go and wait inside the shop, Mr. Frost.
You animal.
Yeah, well, it takes one to know one, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Frost, please.
Come on, get in.
We're going to have to take him with us.
What, have him in a car?
Well, we haven't got a roof rack.
Well, can't we wait for the van?
It's been 54.
I don't think this is a good idea. I think I'm going to be sick.
Come on. Come on, out you get.
I'm sorry I was sick on your jumper. I think I know what did it, besides all that running. I didn't have my usual tea and toast at Joe's. I went for the full breakfast. I knew it was a big mistake with the bacon and
just
the eggs.
Just shut up, will you? Why do we do this job, Tom?
So it wouldn't happen in the Foreign Legion.
Careful.
Yes.
All right, lads?
Yeah. What are you doing back here?
DPG throwing you out already, have they?
Just bringing some stuff back from my locker. About to go back out on duty, as it happens.
Well, this is why you're summed up, yeah?
Yeah.
So what's it like working in the West End?
Brilliant. I've been looking after VIPs and foreign royalty, mainly. Got to be in Belgravia at 10 o'clock, guarding some diplomat's house.
What's that smell?
It's me, Mike. Just been sick in the car.
You're joking. This is what I'm coming back to, is it?
Come on.
Why do you think I stole that whiskey, eh? Why do you think I took it?
Well, I'm going to take a wild guess here, Kingsley. But I reckon it's because you wanted to drink it.
I thought you'd think that. Well, you're wrong, see?
So why did you take it?
Because they wouldn't give me back my hat.
Your hat?
The boy from that shop. Came up behind me in the park yesterday, grabbed it off me head, and ran off with it. Now, my father wore that hat at the 1946 Kilkenny Carlow Festival. Do you know what Judge Ronan O'Connor said?
Look, Kingsley.
That he'd never heard such bass from such a small man.
Kingsley.
Brian O'Lynn was a gentleman born. His hair it was long, and his beard was unshorn.
Kingsley.
His teeth were far out, and his eyes were far in. I'm a natural beauty, says Brian O'Lynn.
Brian O'Lynn was a gentleman born.
Dave, what's happening with Kingsley O'Leary?
We've bailed him, sir.
Really?
Yeah, he's got an address, so we sent him home.
Good. Well, CID need a favour. Mr. Deakin wants some case papers taken over to Barton Street.
All right, OK.
OK, finish your refs first. Let me know if the DI says thank you.
Let's go join Mike.
Oh, no, no, just be going on about what a great time he's been having.
Come on. Has that smell gone yet?
I've taken my jumper off.
Mike's been persuading me to join the DPG. Basically, I've just spent the last 3 months earning twice what I get here for half the amount of work.
Very happy for you, Mike.
And the women, I have never seen so much crumpet.
What's that about, crumpet?
I was just telling the lads about the DPG, Sarge.
Oh, yeah? How's it going?
Well, basically, the work's great, the money's great, and there's wall-to-wall Tommy.
And he doesn't want to come back.
Who said that?
You did.
When?
In the yard. You said something, I can't remember what.
What would you rather do, Dave? Earn a fortune in overtime doing sweet FA, or run around all day chasing tramps? I wouldn't mind joining the DPG full-time, as it happens. I've had enough of frontline policing. As far as I'm concerned, it's for mugs.
Hang on a minute, Mike. Why did you say you come in?
I've got to put some stuff back in my locker.
Yeah, well, you could have done that when you started back. You're just in the show off, aren't you?
What are you talking about?
Yeah, all this talk of overtime and crumpet.
Yeah, you're just winding us up.
Bit jealous, are we, lads?
Definitely a bit full of himself.
He's been going on about this big red Cavalier he's been driving and his 9mm semi-automatic.
That's not fair. All you've got is a baton and a panda.
Yeah, I know.
Where'd he get that tan?
2 weeks in the Seychelles.
Look at him. Look. Yeah. He's showing him his weapon.
9mm of it.
As long as he doesn't get it out.
Keep chatting up with girls.
Yeah, he might get anywhere.
You want to bet?
He fixes John Wayne, look.
Oi, Mike! You all went that way. sort him out when he gets back.
Why wait till then? He's on guard duty in the West End, isn't he? But why don't we pay him a little visit?
There you go. I'm having nothing to do with this.
I just want to use the phone. Time, watch the door, will you?
Are you sure we can get to the West End or back in an hour?
George, find out where he's on guard duty.
Yeah, all right. What are you going to do to him anyway?
Hello? Hello, Ryan. Yeah, it's Dave here.
Mr. Munro finds out, you're on your own.
Ryan, I just wondered if I could borrow those rifles. Yeah. Yeah, they're good, are they? No, it's somebody I want to sort out, that's all. Okay. Okay, look, I'll meet you around the back in about 15 minutes. Okay, thanks, mate. Bye.
Who's that then? Arms dealer?
Sort of. Come on, let's go and see how George is doing.
Dave, you've got to get these case papers to Barton Street.
We'll get Reg to do it.
Hey, lads, he's at it again.
Is it she the one you fancy? Go on, George, go and find out where he's going to be working.
All right.
I'm right, though, aren't I? Is it she the one you're after?
Might be.
Bye.
Oh, Mike, you off?
Yeah.
Tony says you're working near Downing Street.
No, it's nearer South Kent.
Oh, whereabouts?
Trafalgar Mews.
Right.
See you later, George.
Yeah.
So what exactly are we getting off this bloke? Machine guns? Kalashnikovs? Who is he anyway?
He's my nephew. Be careful what you say to him at the moment. He's a bit touchy.
Hey?
His goldfish just died. Ryan, all right, this is Tony. Tony, this is Ryan.
Hi, Ryan.
So, are these the ones you got for your birthday then?
Yeah, this one's a mega soaker, but this one's the best. It's called the Master Blaster.
Brilliant.
Well, I'm not going to need a bat by 12, yeah?
Right. What sort of range have they got?
I'll show you.
Yes, that's brilliant. How about it, Mike, with these then?
Ranger from Sierra Oscar 517 receiving.
Go ahead, 517.
Got an unattended vehicle. Can you do me a check, please? Lima 282, Golf Hotel X-ray.
Stand by. Re-vehicle check. No reports received. Register keeper, Mr. Allen of E1, over.
Received.
All right.
Morning.
Morning.
Morning, sir.
Noticed about Mike, but you know, he's done the firearms course, the advanced driving. It's like he's always trying to prove something.
He's not going to prove much at the DPG.
Driving around the West End, standing guard outside somebody's house. Talk about boring.
You'll be brain dead to do it.
What do they call it? They call it retirement without telling the commissioner.
Right, so the plan is we drive up fast, get out, and we let him have it.
Well, no. Don't you think we should chat to him first, wind him up a bit?
No, we got taken by surprise. Of course, there is one potential problem.
Oh, what's that?
Got to check they haven't got security cameras.
Yeah, Oscar from 358 receiving.
Go ahead, Gary.
Just arrived at the general store off the Netherlake, Sarge. Suspect has ran off. Informant confirms it was Kingsley O'Leary.
Oh,
looks like extensive criminal damage. Over.
Received.
What's he doing going back to the shop?
We'll let someone else sort it out.
Did he take anything at all, Mr. Frost?
I've told you, he just smashed this. He came in going crazy. Kept saying he wanted his hat back. He was completely drunk. He accused my son of nicking his hat. Anyway, why did you let him go so soon? These people should be banged up, eh?
Sierra.
Oscar from 358 receiving.
Go ahead, Dave.
Can't take a look for the suspect, Sarge. I'm due in court.
Well, in that case, we'd better use the panda.
Oh, we can't, sir.
Oh?
Reg is on his way back from Barton Street. Apparently Mr. Deakin wanted some urgent case papers dropping off.
Oh, really? Well, I asked Sarah Wan to take them.
Okay, I reckon we need to go via Sloane Square.
Sierra 1 from Sierra Oscar receiving.
Better answer that. Go on, Dave. They probably want us to go and pick up Kingsley O'Leary.
Well, we're telling him we went off watch to take a witness statement.
What witness statement?
Sierra 1 from Sierra Oscar, are you receiving? Over.
Sierra 1 from Sierra Oscar receiving. So, where are they?
What are you doing?
Going back to Sunhill.
But we're nearly there. It'll only take a couple of minutes.
If Munro is onto us, he's going to stick us on, or fine us, anything. I'm not going to risk that. Not for the sake of a prank.
Well, I'll take full responsibility.
Oh, yeah.
I'll tell him that I led you astray. Oh, come on, Tone. Come on, let's wipe the smile off Mike's face. Come on. Look, you saw the way he was showing off. You saw him chatting up that girl. Tony, he called us mugs. Come on, we need to teach him a lesson.
Only if I get to use the Master Blaster.
Okay.
Yes!
No, there's no security cameras, Tony. It's a residential road.
Let's drive in the other end. Take a proper look.
Oh, no. He's not stopping.
Maybe he'll turn round.
Nah.
He's going to want to know what we're doing on his ground.
Doesn't look like it. Game on, Tony.
Up, Matthew. I need someone to look for Kingsley O'Leary. Gary McCann's in court and Sierra One seems to have disappeared.
Oh, right.
Are you busy?
Well, I'm a bit behind with my APA, sir. What about Luke Ashton? He's around somewhere.
Right. I don't suppose you know what's happened to Tony and Dave?
Well, Tony said something about chasing a bail absconder.
Bail absconder?
Pretty sure that's what he said, yeah.
Well, Reg Hollis seemed to think they were visiting a potential informant.
No. Really?
Funny, eh?
You ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yes!
Then go, 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 go!
What are you doing?
On the ground.
Get down on the ground. Spread your arms, spread your legs.
Come on!
Oh, is this some kind of joke?
Stop!
Oh, what are you playing at? Stop at your prats!
Then get on the ground, then!
Too good for our nick, are ya?
Call us mugs!
Oh, my governor's gonna be here in a minute! Pack it in!
Where are the keys?
What?
Only kidding.
Come on!
Bastards!
That was brilliant!
It's got to be the highlight of my career!
He couldn't believe it! He is never, never gonna forgive us for that!
Pack it in! My gun's gonna be in a minute! Pack it in!
Ah, there you are, Luke. You busy at the moment?
Just about to interview a prisoner, sir. He said he'd give me some information about the Canley Road burglaries in return for a cup of tea and a biscuit. Can't be bad, eh?
Right, well, you better get on with it then before he changes his mind.
Sir.
Everything all right, sir?
Anything from Tony and Dave?
No, I don't think so.
So, it looks like I'm the only one free to go after Kingsley O'Leary.
What?
It's our friend again.
He's pulling us over.
See us with Mike, did he?
We'll soon find out. not looking very happy.
This could bite your pension, mate.
What's up, lads? Got lost?
No, sir. No, I don't think so.
Inspector Roger Crean, West End Central.
PC Quinnan, this is PC Stamp, Sun Hill. Well, we were following a suspect, sir, and, well, basically, he's taking us off our ground.
Oh, right.
Yeah, known drug dealer. We thought that if we tailed him, he may have led us to his supplier.
And you managed to follow him all the way from Sun Hill without him seeing him?
Oh, well, that's just it, sir. I think he probably saw us a few miles back, decided to lead us on a wild goose chase.
Yeah.
We've been driving around like a couple of monkeys.
Yeah, looks like it.
Sierra 1 from Sierra, Oscar receiving, over.
Do you mind if I take that, sir? Yeah, go ahead, Sarge.
So what's the name of this dealer?
Gerald Briggs.
Yeah, sorry, Sarge, we were off watch for a few minutes.
Where have you been, over? Sierra 1, where have you been, over?
I'm not exactly free to speak at the moment, over.
Yeah, well, when you are free to speak, Dave, perhaps you'll call in, over.
Received, Sarge, over.
George, what's going on?
Well, no idea, Sarge. Honest?
Do you reckon he believed us?
Oh, yeah. He also believes in the tooth fairy. Let's just get out of here, shall we?
There's no sign of Kingsley O'Leary on the Netherlake, June. Any word from the homeless hostel, over?
They haven't phoned, sir, but you have had a call from an Inspector Crane at West End Central. Wants you to call back, over.
Oh, no.
Do you know what is concerning, June? Over.
I'd better not say on air, sir. Over.
Didn't believe us. Dead.
Give it to me! Give me my hat! It's mine! Give me the hat!
Oi! Are you all right?
I got it!
What are you doing? Now open the door! Open this door! Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 1 receiving.
Go ahead, sir.
Yeah. Assistance required on the Netherlake, George. Some local kids have locked me in one of the garages under Stanby House. Over.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra 1. We can deal. On way. Over.
Glad to hear you're back with us at long last, Dave. Over.
Ryan O'Lynn was a gentleman born. His head was long and his beard
Sierra
was
one
unshorn.
From Sierra Oscar 1.
His teeth were far out and his eyes were far in. I'm a natural beauty, said Ryan O'Lynn. This might be a good time for you to take my statement.
After I've arrested you for criminal damage, you mean?
It may have escaped your notice. I've just been the victim of a vicious assault. I'm not the only one those kids keep having a go at, you know.
It's happened before, has it?
Oh, loads of times. And I've been one of the lucky ones. My mate Frank Hughes had his arm broken by those boys, and that was after they were through kicking him.
Was this reported?
Oh, sure, yeah. Be a great point in that, wouldn't there?
Yes, there would.
He's not happy about the hostel being opened, you see. So he pays the kids to kick us off the estate. He told me.
Who?
Frost. The shop owner. Do you know what else he told me? That the only thing I was fit for was the gas chamber.
Down there.
You can do the talking.
There's no problem, Tone. We'll just tell Monroe what we told Crane. That we were following a suspicious car.
And why the radio silence?
Well, we're saying we were out of range.
Should have done the usual termites, locker upside down, talcum powder in the pocket.
That's pathetic.
I'd wear his water pistols and mature, I suppose.
See ya. Sir? Sir? Sir, it's Dave Quinnan!
Well, open the door!
Hang on, Dave. Go on. You all right, sir?
I've arrested Mr. O'Leary for criminal damage. Bring him in for me, will you? And I want you in my office at the end of the shift. You've got some explaining to do.
You dare say you feel sick?
I want to talk to you in a minute. Stay where you are. Where's your dad?
You got him yet?
Oh, Mr. Frost?
Yes?
Inspector Munro. Mr. Frost, are you aware that inciting people to violence is a criminal offence?
Oi, what are you doing? Waiting for a bus?
Oh, it's Dave and Tony, Sergeant. They're in with Mr. Munro.
Yeah, he hasn't got his cane out yet, though, sir.
Well, I'm sure they'll tell you about it later. Come on.
Inspector Crane says he stopped you, on the Chelsea embankment?
Yes, sir. We'd already lost a suspect and we were on our way back.
And you say this suspect is a, known dealer?
Yes, sir.
So you felt it was worthwhile to go off division and lose radio contact just because there was a chance this dealer might, do a deal in broad daylight?
Well, he might have led us back to his supplier, sir.
Well, Sergeant Boyden tried to make out you were chasing a bail absconder. Reg said you were the potential informant. George thought you were taking a witness statement. All of them covering for you. I'm probably the only one in the nick who doesn't know what you've been up to. Oh, come on. Tell me. I feel a bit left out. Or was it something funny? Well, why don't we see if I've got a sense of humour? If I do find out what you've been up to, off division, ignoring calls, leaving me to cover for you, believe me, your feet won't touch the ground. Now, out.
Sir?
Oh, Mike?
Sir, there's someone in the front office who wants to see you.
What about?
Dave and Tony.
You should have seen him. We told him, get down on the ground.
Arms out, legs out.
And he did. He got down on the ground.
And what did you do then?
We just carried on doing it.
Yeah, of course.
And how wet was he?
He was dripping. But those kids' rifles had a business.
Yeah, they were great. But he had to go and change uniforms.
Like that. He was absolutely
tough. He was.
Hey, Mike. All right.
What, you come back with your waterproofs, I suppose?
Having a good laugh, eh?
Yeah.
But you thought that was really funny. I'll tell you what's really funny. My governor turned up soon after and wanted to know what happened.
Oh,
yeah, I'll tell you something else that's really funny. Yeah. This is hilarious!
What's going on?
Come on, come on, let's go down a pub.
What if Mike goes in?
Oh, he'll be all right.
You're kidding, he wants blood.
Oh, good, you haven't gone. I've got someone here who wants to make a complaint.
Sir?
You said you'd bring the rifles back by 12.
My office?